from Helmet's latest CD, Betty, on Interscope Atlantic Records, and we are currently on the tour bus with Helmet, and we are here with two members of Helmet, and you are?
Rob. And Henry.
And,
bass.
Me, guitar. No.
Guitar.
Bass. Guitar.
We got it. Right now you guys are on your third leg of the tour, right? Pretty much?
Yeah, pretty much. We just came back from New Zealand, Japan, and we started touring States for like a month now, again.
So, I mean, since you've been on the road for so long, do the shows get more routine, or is it still, you guys are on stage, do you still feel like it's like you just start the tour or what?
I mean, you still have to win them over every night, but it's like a big blur, pretty much, for me anyway, I don't know.
How about for you?
Yeah, so it can get kind of a little monotonous towards the end, you know, we've been out since June, so it's a little, you can get a little tired.
Either way.
Yeah, but it's tough. You know, you want to try to put on a good show, and there's kids who want to come out and see you play, and it's inspiring, especially if the audience is really into it.
So, I mean, like, Phil from Pantera once said, like, their Pantera style is like a power groove, and, like, to me, when I listen to, like, Helmet, it's like, I almost get that same feel, because it's like, any song you listen to with Helmet, it's like almost, you gotta, like, kind of bob your head and stuff like that. How would you describe the music of Helmet, if you can? I know how artists hate to do that, but in a nutshell.
Yeah, it is the groovy, pretty, you know.
I mean, because it's not like just sit there and listen to the rhythm, you just got to get into it. I mean, do you get into the music? Is that a major part of when you write the songs, or?
The riffy part of it, yeah, definitely.
You're striving.
It's all very, like, bare essential, riff-oriented, you know.
Right.
Music, so.
No, I read that, like, this album was probably the most funnest you guys had in writing an album. I mean, why was it?
Yeah, it was pretty fun, because a lot of it had to do with T-Ray, who got production credit for it. And it was a little more experimental and opened a lot more doors and stuff, so in that way it was a lot more fun.
Right. Right now we're fixing to play Wilma's Rainbow, yet another cut from Betty, and anything you want to tell me about that song?
Trippy. It's pretty trippy. It's our psychedelic video. It's was done by Alex Winter, who was either Bill or Ted in Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. Which one was he?
I don't know.
It was the blonde one.
Ted, yeah.
That's him. He made it for us. He's a friend of ours from New York and shot it in London. We wear green body socks and it's really trippy.
Yeah, it's a great video. Favorite song on that CD, so check out Wilma's Rainbow, and we'll be back with more Helmet in a second.
We are ready.
Hey, that was Unsung. That was Unsung. That was the Japanese version from Helmet. And, you want to start it over?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. We'll try to do that again.
Splice it together.
How about that Mets game? Hey, that was Unsung from Helmet, but that was a version that you're probably unfamiliar with. That was from when you guys were with Amphetamine Reptile Records. Remember those days?
Oh, that was way before me, actually.
Yeah, was that the one with the cockroach?
You got it.
Yeah, we did that video for, $600 or something. A film student friend of ours decided he wanted to make a video for us.
Now, what made you guys want to redo that song for...
All that was happening when we were sort of got some serious hype on the band, and we sort of were switching over to a major label. And everyone at the label and our management decided that was our hit single, our most poppy and most commercially acceptable song, so we wanted to...
do you guys ever cringe when you hear, like, an old Helmet song on the radio? Or are you kind of the band that like to play off their past? Like, a lot of bands, well, they'll hear, like, an old song, they're like, ugh, you know, why are they playing that? I mean, you ever feel that way sometimes?
Actually, not really. I get a little tired of hearing that song.
It's like, yeah, kids in the front row screaming Unsung all night long. It's like, we do have another record, you know? It's like, excuse me.
But it's not that bad.
Yeah.
But you do give the kids what they want, right?
Oh, yeah.
Give them what they want.
Now, how do you guys feel about, like, bootlegging? Because I know, is that ever a problem with your shows, or...?
Big problem, actually, yeah. It a lot of money is being made off of that, and unfortunately none of it is going to us, so
right.
It's a pretty serious dangerous kind of thing.
Right. I mean, have you ever caught anyone in the process of doing stuff like that?
You catch kids with like recorders and stuff like that, but you know, actually there was one, whatever, the kid had to give up like the actual plates or whatever like that. But
well, I mean, how much input do you guys have in the videos?
We're not filmmakers, so what we try to do is look for people that have interesting ideas, interesting gimmicks or something like that. But you know, we like to try to say, like, you know, make sure that it doesn't suck.
I mean, do you ever have an idea that you try to convey to them, and you know?
Yeah, no, maybe in the future, you know, we'll write out a little storyline or something, or act, and you know, big orchestra, and our bride get married, and then the bride will die, and Rob will do some big solo out in the desert by church.
There you go. Right now, we pitched your break, and we'll be back with more Helmet and even Milk Toast. So stay tuned for that. Check in a little bit.
What's up?
Beer's coming.
Alright, guys, we
got a
bus through.
Stop the liquor. Okay. You still on me, right? That's over, or are you going to go on another?
It's over for the holidays, and we start again on the 10th or something like that of January.
Okay. You want to wait for them then?
First is the 26th.
Stop it.
So, John, you take it, John.
I'm sorry, yeah.
Yeah, we'll be. Start off over there. Don't start over there, that's fine.
Whenever you're ready. How's your
day? You still hear that, right? About that Bears game. Hey, that was Unsung. Helmet, it's probably a video you probably haven't really seen before. It's the amphetamine reptile version there. How'd you like that video?
I like it a lot.
Now we're joined with
John,
who is the drummer, right?
The drummer.
Now,
and that's Rob, he plays guitar.
Yeah, we've been through this already.
Yeah, and that's Henry over there. Well, hey, what made you guys want to redo Unsung for Meantime?
What, you mean the video? Or
yeah, I mean,
because the video, the song is really old. We did it a 7-inch a long time ago, and then we put it on Meantime. That video is really old, so because it's a good song, I guess.
I mean, it was your probably. Was Unsung with that was Helmet with Unsung. And that was a variation of that song and video that you probably heard not a lot of times, because that was the amphetamine reptile version, right?
Right.
And we were joined with
John,
and he is the
drummer.
Oh,
Helmet,
there you go. What made you guys want to redo that for Meantime?
Because we like the song a lot.
Okay, Enough said. Do you guys ever like cringe when you like hear old Helmet stuff play on the radio? Like, you ever like listen to it? You know, why are they playing that song? Why don't they play something off the new album?
No, I like our old stuff. I like it a lot.
For example,
how old? I like all our songs.
There you go. Oh, how much input do you guys have in the videos, making the videos?
It's usually pretty planned out on what it's going to be. We get video treatments.
I mean, do you guys ever have the say of what is going to be in the video and what's not going to be in the video?
You mean if they want us to appear naked in tutus or something?
Yeah, I mean, if you guys ever say, oh, I don't want to do that, it's going to be stupid. I mean, do they ever say, okay, let's write that out?
I don't think we've had to do that yet. Okay. Have we?
No. Usually it's been pretty smooth, and the video director is usually in charge of the whole thing, and if we don't like something, yeah, we do have say in it, but so far we haven't complained about anything.
Well, there you go. Right now we pitch to a break. We'll be back with more Helmet and Milk Toast, so check it out. Equipment, huh?
Yeah.
You guys ever like when you play have really crappy equipment?
At one time we did, yes.
Back in the early days. Oh, welcome back to VidoZoo. Still here with Helmet. We're still with
John,
Rob,
and Henry over there.
Henry.
Right now we're gonna play Milk Toast from the Crow motion picture soundtrack. Was that song Milk Toast ever?
Okay.
It's all right. It adds to the spontaneity of the. Was that song, I mean, written specifically for the soundtrack, or was that written for Betty and just contributed to the movie soundtrack?
It was just contributed to the soundtrack. It's an old song.
Pretty old song. So, I mean, I know you probably guys get sick of answering the question of just another victim with House of Pain and stuff like that. How was that collaboration worked out? Was it something like they said, we want Helmet, or was it, you know, Helmet saying, you know, it'd be cool to do something with House of Pain?
No, we didn't know who we were going to be working with, and then we found out it was House of Pain, and we did it in 4 days, two in New York, when they were on tour, and then when we went on tour, we finished it in L.A., where they live.
So when you guys ever asked to do any more, I mean, because you did the one for The Crow, Judgment Night, I mean, is there any other ones in the works?
We're in the Jerky Boys movie, and we have a song for Johnny something movie. Johnny Mnemonic.
There you go. And when, okay. And is that's going to be on the soundtrack, right?
Yeah.
Okay, right now we're going to play Milk Toast from Helmet, and we'll be right back with more Helmet. See ya. All right. Let me just get over here. You guys enjoying the weather today, or? Thanks for staying with us here at VidoZoo. Right now we are joined. We're still with Helmet, as you can tell, and right now we are with who are we here with?
Scott Weiland.
And he is the
what?
You're the roadie.
Yeah.
There you go. As far as with Helmet, what kind of direction is it gonna go, like lyrically and musically? Anybody?
Lyrically, that's the main
part. It's got to be a lot more like Black Sabbath and Stone Temple Pilots and.
No, like that Sammy Hagar song.
Yeah, Sammy Hagar, High Hopes. That song, High Hopes, Sammy Hagar did. Really love
that.
Yeah. What about musically?
Sammy Hagar-ish.
Is Helmet ever plan on releasing like a home video? Because I mean, a lot of bands are doing that now. And I mean, is there anything like that in the works for you guys?
No.
You could if you would, but you don't want to.
We've never discussed it.
Okay. Well, thanks for staying with us here at Video Zoo, and thanks for Helmet for hanging out on the tour bus. I've had a great time. I know you have. So check out the last video on Video Zoo, and thanks for staying with us. See you next week. Rockin'.